What do you think my question is going to be? Why did I wait 31 days to call 911?
911, what's your emergency?
My daughter's been missing for the last 31 days.
During the trial, the complete 911 call was played for the jury.
Why didn't you call 31 days ago?
I've been looking for her and have gone through other resources to try to find her, which was stupid.
All right, guys, what's going on? Hope you're having a great day. Thanks to all my subs, members. If you're not a sub and you're new to the channel, would love to have you. So that being said, let's jump right into it. How'd y'all like that little intro there with the Casey Anthony clips? So Casey Anthony waits to call. She waits 31 days to call to report her daughter missing. And you heard what the dispatcher said. She's like, man, why did you wait 31 days to call and report your daughter missing? And she goes on with this mumbo jumbo about, you know, going through other resources or something like that and saying that it was stupid. Kind of makes you wonder what's on the Summer Wells 911 calls, right? Makes you wonder. Just makes you wonder. Because we all know that they're holding on to those. And then, you know, Casey, you know, later we learn that Casey claims that her daughter was taken by, you know, allegedly Casey claimed that she was taken by Zanita Gonzalez, you know, the nanny, you know, the nanny thing. And, you know, after that lady got thrown under the bus and it all blew up on her, she came out and was like, she made it clear. I don't even know this girl. Don't know her family. Don't know none of them. And, you know, just it kept going on from there. I remember seeing, you know, during that 31 days, I remember seeing a video clip of a tattoo artist. Y'all remember the Casey Anthony got a tattoo, Bella Vita? Well, the tattoo artist, you know, asked about Casey's daughter, and Casey's like, oh, she's with the nanny. But really, you know, Kaylee was already dead. A lot of questionable activity from Casey during that 31 days that her daughter was dead. And then in some interviews, you know, Casey goes on to say that she had a bad family life. And here's where the cycle, you know, here's where the stuff comes back in. And I just keep, there's a lot of stuff in the Casey Anthony investigation that could very well be applied to the Summer Wells investigation. I realize that. A lot of the lies, you know, so it's going to be interesting to see how many lies come out in the Summer Wells investigation. You know, the jury was saying that they could something about charging Casey with lying to the police and all that, but the abuse, you know, she's talking about her dad and brother had done some bad stuff to her when she was little. See, Candace had some bad stuff done to her when she was little. She had some bad stuff probably done to her she did have some bad stuff done to her when she was married to her first husband, Simon. So, but, yeah, Casey said that some bad stuff was done to her. Now, she said her brother wasn't as bad to her as her dad was. And, I mean, if it is true, I'll tell you, I studied the family. You know, I went back and looked at some video clips and I studied the family. And I do believe that is a messed up family. I believe they're emotionally messed up and psychologically messed up. Something's going on in that family. Because watching an interview with Cindy and George, which is Casey Anthony's mom and dad, Casey Anthony's mom, Cindy, got so frustrated with George. Now, mind you, they agreed to sit down to these interviews and, you know, answer questions. But apparently she blows up and tells George that he's telling too much information and walks off the set. And I found that really, really strange because I'm like, you know, why? I mean, here they are doing this stuff when they could be, what you say could be held against you in a court of law. Why even do the interviews to begin with then? Right? Weird. And here in the Summer Wells case, multiple news interviews, right? Candace walks off the Dr. Phil show. But it wasn't because Dawn was saying too much. It was because she felt she was being interrogated. But another similarity, you know, Cindy Anthony walks off during I don't know who it was, but anyway, it was an interview. But anyway, Cindy Anthony walks off and leaves George. And on Dr. Phil, and on Dr. Phil, Candace walks off and leaves Dawn. Both families, emotionally and psychologically messed up, in my opinion. Now, how did Casey Anthony get acquitted, right? I looked it up. That was my main thing. Now, I followed it, but I didn't follow it like I should have. I was just like, and YouTube wasn't around back then, I don't think. Yeah, I think it was, but it wasn't as big as it is now, and I don't know. But man, let me tell you, if I had a YouTube channel back then, yeah, I'd have been on this like stink on, anyway. Yeah, I looked up why Casey Anthony got acquitted. And I found out, and here's another thing that can be applied to the Summer Wells investigation. One of the jurors talked to the news after the trial, and here's what he told them. He said, prosecutors did not give us enough evidence to convict. They gave us a lot of stuff that makes us think she probably did do something wrong, but not beyond a reasonable doubt. And again, this can be applied to the Summer Wells investigation. They gave us a lot of stuff that makes us think she probably did do something wrong, but not beyond a reasonable doubt. So, therein lies, in my opinion, the situation we currently have with the Summer Wells investigation. So, in saying that, you know, I've decided to be patient with the investigation. You know, if Summer's gone, ain't no bringing her back anyway, right? Now we can bring her back and give her a dignified, you know, resting place and a dignified goodbye. But other than that, obviously she needs justice. But, I mean, if it takes 2, 3, 4 years, I don't want someone in the jury saying, well, we couldn't convict because we couldn't convict beyond a reasonable doubt. We couldn't convict them beyond a reasonable doubt. They didn't give us enough evidence to convict them beyond a reasonable doubt. I don't want that to happen here. Now, I've said that earlier in some other videos I've made, we don't want, and again, the situation going on with Barry Morphew, right? He's still a free man. And I guarantee you, because this right here, not enough evidence to convict. So, like I said, if it takes them 2 more years in the Summer Wells case, I'm okay with it. I just don't want an acquittal over not enough evidence to convict. So, guys, let me know what you think. Now, I didn't do a whole 2-hour spiel of the Casey Anthony thing, but I did want to go over it and cover it and give you my thoughts and opinions on it. I could have done a 2-hour thing on it and showed some really graphic stuff and didn't want to do that. There's all kinds of stuff I could have played and showed in the whole investigation. But, I read your comments and I hear you say, thank you for not taking 2 hours to do this. But, keeping you guys happy. That's what I do. I keep it, even on my live streams, I think I try to keep it down to an hour. So, and that's a rare thing when I do a live stream. So, but that's basically the gist and the coverage, a very short coverage of, the Casey Anthony, thing from old Don B here. So, let me know what you think about the stuff in the Casey Anthony, trial and information, the lies, the stuff that I brought up. Let me know what y'all think about that, comparing that to the Summer Wells investigation. You think I'm spot on again? Think old Don B's spot on again? Let me know. Let me know in the comments. And who knows? We may even go over the O.J. Simpson thing in the next couple days. Y'all want me to do that? And if you want me to do an in-depth thing, whether it's an hour, if you want me to go a full-blown hour on it and do a good in-depth thing and show a bunch of pictures and all that stuff, let me know. I can do it. But I do have a lot of you that say, I hate these 2-hour videos where they could do it in maybe 30 minutes or so. So let me know what you think. Let me know. Do you want me to do longer videos? Is the 10 to 15, 20 minute videos that I do long enough? Or do you want me to do some that are longer? So let me know in the comments below, guys. Appreciate you for hanging out with me. And I'll see you on the next video.